Okay, so I'm doing a three-part series, basically three videos with three different pours, but they're all going to be together in the end, like brother and sister. Anyhow, yes, these are my pictures in the background. If you go to carlmazer.com, you can see a lot of my pictures on there and some of my art. So I had some paint left over from another pour. That's why I'm doing these three small ones. So the colors are, there's aqua, there's a deep blue, cobalt blue, and a phthalo green. First, I'm going to start with the white because I like to have the white and then it goes into the dark blue. So let me see here. Let me see my pattern. I'm going to go like this. Okay, got it. And I can go ahead and work with this a little bit. Get this white down here because there's going to be some negative space in there. And these are super easy to do. You will love it. Get across there like that. I know I'm cutting off the camera, but okay, got that out of the way. So then I'm going to come in with the light. Whoa. One by one. I have this song stuck in my head. It's a reggae song. And it's a powerful song. Okay. I get this on there. And this is the phthalo green. And then the cobalt. And this already had silicone and everything in it. The song I was listening to was by Skip Marley. It's like Bob Marley's grandson. He has some really good stuff. You gotta check it out. And then Stephen Marley. I don't know who Steven is in the mix of the Marleys, but I get that on the side there. I just want to make sure the sides cover because it looks really cool when the sides are nice and done. Okay, so now we're gonna do this swipe. Ooh, that's a lot of paint, but it's awesome. Whoa, that's cool. Very cool, baby, very cool. Oh yeah, baby. Thank you, Austin Powers. I'm gonna see if I can blow this little part out there. I mean, the cells popped up. I didn't even need to use this. In one of the other videos, I show you my mix, so you don't have to worry about that. Kind of do that little number. One thing I like about this Walmart white paint, it dries nice and fast. It's cheap, it dries nice and fast, and I love it. Make sure this is covered. Get some more paint up there. Get that nice and spread out evenly. So what's nice about the white paint that it dries fast is it holds those cells on to the canvas, and it doesn't, since it doesn't stay wet so long, it, that's nice because it just holds it in there. You know how when you do a painting and you come back an hour later and it's completely different and the cells are ruined and you're just crying? That's what this Walmart paint has helped stop. So I'm really happy about that. Oh, not too much though. I don't want to make it too much. Just a little bit. Okay. So there is that one. Love it. Just a little hair more up there. Get on there. Yeah, it starts to set up pretty quick, and I think the glue helps it along even more so. Well, I'm not too hip on that. It's a little too bold. I can't have it too bold. There we go. Awesome. I'm gonna leave it alone. And these are all the same color pattern with the dark blue in the middle and the negative space white on the outside. And I just really love it. It had really nice cells come out. I didn't use that much silicone at all, just a couple of drops. So I have some leftover paint that I already have mixed up, and I'm going to use that. So I have some aqua. This is by Liquitex. I don't really care for it. The Liquitex likes to have little bubbles in it and whatnot. I'm sure I can figure out a way how to get that out of there. But this is metallic, Artist Loft Metallic Cobalt Blue. This is Thalo Green, Artist Loft Metallic Thalo Green. This is Artist Loft Metallic Blue. Gonna do a little bit of silicone in there. Not three drops, but I'm gonna go one drop because I don't have that much paint in there. That's an airplane going over. We live next to an airport, so I'm gonna barely stir it. Barely stir. You knew that was coming. So I need just a little bit of white done up. So I'm going to use a little bit of Floetrol in there. Not a ton. I don't want to have too much paint left over. A little bit of glue, just a little Elmer's glue. Boop. And then a little bit of white, not a lot. And that one's jacked up. Perfect. Pretty much like my night. So I'm gonna mix that up. And I'm not gonna put any silicone in the white. So as you can see, the consistency is a little bit, I have it a little bit thicker. I'm gonna try a little bit thicker white on this one. And since I'm doing black here, I'm gonna pour the white along here. To make good contrast. I'll bump that other cup. Knock it off. I'm gonna get this to come down a little bit more. I want this to come over on the sides. Really nice. Really nice. Really nice. And then let's go this color. I need to set these out of the way. Actually, let's go the aqua color because I want to stay another light color. Oh yeah, that's gonna be cool. Who knows, I might not even need to swipe this. It might just be, I'm gonna push that up against that white, just a hair. I'm not wiping it on my shorts here. I have a towel down here. Now I'm going to go a dark. Oh, you know what? I might just do the dark right in the middle. Whoa, that was a lot. Then I'm gonna do the cobalt blue. Oh, this is gonna look cool. And then now the phthalo green. And just a little bit of it in there. Let's kind of drag that through a little bit. I'm gonna try and get this covered up a little bit. Okay, should I swipe it? Let's try it. Let's just do one very carefully. I want that to really drip over and cover so I can get it on the sides there because I want the sides to look really cool like that. Now I'm going to, this one is like a little too small, but And I want to just get on there just a little bit. Wipe that off. I almost need to be at a little angle here. Oh, this one's gonna be fun. Right now, I'm trying to get some of the paint off of there, because that's a lot of paint. That looks really cool. Let's hit it with a heat gun, embossing tool. Heat up a little bit. I almost kind of need to tilt it just a hair. So that is really cool looking. Need to get a little bit more on the sides here. So I'm gonna drag some of this paint over and just splash that right on there like that. And it doesn't have to be perfect on the sides, just as long as it's covered, because it will run down. Oh, I guess I could have pulled some of the paint up from there. Duh. Like I said, it's been one of those nights, so. But I like that. You saw how I only used one drop of silicone, and see those cells? I might do just a hair more white down here, just because I'm that picky. I want it to be really contrasty. Now I can hear a train way back there. Cool. I'm just getting all kinds of cool stuff tonight. Let that run over. I'm going to pour some more white on here. Let that run over a little bit. Kind of do that number. See, now it's a little more contrasty. And who knows, I might not pour the black sand on there. I like this a lot. Some of that paint get in there. Oh yeah, I like how it's mixing down in here. Don't want to get it too hot, because this is really super hot, but I just kind of want to push it around a little bit. Whoop. Not too much, don't burn myself. Oh shoot, I don't want to do that. Okay, stop doing that. That is really super cool. I'm gonna even add a little bit more white to this little side. Right now. I might just leave it negative space. Because I like that look. I really do. I'm just gonna take some more pure white and go right along here, just like that. And then maybe I can brush some of that. Still wanted to have it contrast characteristics, so I don't want to continue swiping. Just trying to get some of that down there. And then I'm going to brush in the rest of that. Just brush ever so lightly. Oh, there was something on there. What in the... Great. I'm not liking this brush set. I bought it at Michael's and it was pretty cheap. I'm not liking it at all. Has hairs that fall off and stuff. Bristles, I mean. Look, there's another one about to fall off. Shikrimanish. Oh, look at that. That's very cool. Just some negative space. Work in there. I don't like to tilt mine too much. If you can tell that in some of my videos, you know. Okay, I'm gonna leave it. Thank you for watching. It has that real ocean kind of look. I'm gonna show you the mix because these were leftover paint, so I'm gonna add in some Floetrol. Floetrol is a water-based paint conditioner. It helps to improve paint flow and workability. It also allows the paint to adjust to more difficult conditions such as hot, cold, and windy environments. It increases translucency for artistic effects like pouring. It helps against crazing and cracking and against bubbles forming, and it's flexible and non-yellowing. Floetrol can be found at Home Depot, on Amazon.com, at Lowe's, and even Walmart. Pretty good amount of it because I'm going to need a lot of white on there. I'm going to add in some glue. This is Elmer's glue, just regular white school glue. And that's a pretty good chunk of it in there. And then I'm going to add some white. And this is just cheap Walmart. I got a quart of Color Place, Walmart Color Place brand white paint, semi-gloss. Don't want to use matte. If you use matte paint, you'll get a lot of cracking going on. So the cup is about this full right now. And get all that stirred together real good. Okay, I'm going to put 2 drops of this spot-on brand treadmill belt lubricant. It's 100% silicone. You can get it on Amazon for like 10 bucks a bottle, sometimes 7. So just 2 tiny drops of that. 1, 2. Bam. Just like that. Then make sure it's shut really good because this stuff will leak all over. Then I'm going to do this. 1, 2, 3. That's it. So I'm ready to pour. All right, so I'm gonna do kind of an S shape on here. We'll start up here, come down. Man, I made that way too thin. Shoot, that's okay. What I meant is I made the stripe way too thin. That's okay though. If it's anything on par for the course of today, how it's been going, whew. But painting makes it better. I did a pour earlier and my upper cam shut off. Like it didn't even record anything. And I was like, what? No way. I'm gonna need some more white up here real quick. And I'm not gonna be afraid to get a lot of white on there. Cause this is all gonna be white up here. Whoa, okay. See what I mean by today? It's just kinda crazy. It's not a full moon. Okay. So now we're gonna go the phthalo green, and I'll show you the colors after. And then this is a cobalt blue, and these are metallic. They're by Artist Loft. I really love Artist Loft paints. It's a Michaels brand paint. And I just love them. I love the way they mix and everything. Okay, and then we're gonna do this a dark right in the middle. Get that all in there. And I want it to go over too. So I'm gonna do this number all real quick. Let's see. Let's make sure that all gets covered. And now I'm gonna do, you know what? I might use my big cake icing tool thing I got. Okay, and now I'm just gonna go right along there, just like this, nice and easy, and go up and over. And let that just drip on down there. Get that some paint over here. And look at those cells right away. I didn't want it down there because I want to paint over that. That looks so cool. Gotta love that. Big old swiping thing. So I don't even have to hit it with the embossing tool or heat gun at all. The cells are really forming good. That means there was a good mixture of silicone in there. Now I'm going to pour on a little more white just on the edges there. Just get that nice and covered. This is just a little band that I poured across there, with some ocean-like colors. And I really love it. I only put a couple of drops of silicone in there. And this white is seriously the Walmart house paint. And I love it because it dries nice and fast, but see how it's holding those cells together? You don't really see any movement in there. And I love it because my paintings hold together really fast. Right now it's a little bubbly because it has some drops of silicone in it, but that will lay out really nice. Okay, here we are. Before I get started, I'm going to clean off most of the silicone with a clean rag and some isopropyl alcohol. And I'm going to go around and lightly just clean the spots. I don't know if you can see here or not. Let me see if I can get on it. You can see some spottiness just barely right on there. But I'm going to clean that off and get rid of that. But this turned out pretty cool. It's not exact, and I wasn't even planning on doing the exact pour at first, but these turned out really cool, and I'm excited about them. So I'm gonna clean these off, do just a little bit of touch up on the white, because like there's some spots where just a little bit of bleed over there, you can see just a hair right there. And I'm going to touch that up and then we're going to do the Mod Podge. Check this out, I got them done as far as the touch up went. And I really love the sides of these. Check out how natural that looks. It's really cool. I'm going to mix up some Mod Podge. I have a little water here, distilled water. And sometimes the Mod Podge thing really sticks on there because it is glue. It's like glue and a sealer coat all in one. Okay, put the lid back on here. And sometimes if you see like weird artifacts in there, go ahead and take that right out. Okay. I get that mixed around. Let me get this right here so you can see what's going on. So I'm gonna do just a little bit of water in there. And the water doesn't have to be mixed perfectly, but I suggest getting it, halfway decent. People ask me about archival stuff, and they ask me, you know, I have people kind of slam me sometimes and say, well, what you do is not archival quality. I don't know why people use glue and Mod Podge and all that stuff. You know why? Because it's cheap. You know, if we want to go out and buy $100 bottle of PVA that's archival quality, we'll do that. But in the meantime, we're going to do this. So I'm just going to start right over the top. And I like to work fast with this stuff because it's really sticky and it likes to dry fast, especially here in Utah. The air is so dry, it dries really fast. See, you can do straight lines like that if you want to. We could even do ocean style lines, which I might do. That's kind of cool. Let's do ocean style lines with it. That way when the Mod Podge dries, you'll see the lines going this way and not a uniform pattern. So let's go ahead and get the sides. And to get the sides, I'm not gonna be really picky. I'm gonna just do a light coat. If I have some what's called holidays in the painting business, oh, see, there's a chunk of whatever. My dad, he was a house painter, and they used to call those holidays where places where you went on a holiday, apparently. Because what am I trying to say? They're light spots. That's what a holiday is. Holiday is just a light spot. Just a light spot, Bob. Carl Ross. But I'm not worried about holidays because if I have any light spots, I'm coming back to do multiple layers anyway, so not too worried about that. Okay, so that one's done. I'm gonna set this one down here so I don't bump it. So, ready for the next one here. And you can do this one of two ways. You can do the sides first, or you can do the top first. Here's an easy trick that I do to do the sides. See how I have some on here? Whoops. See how I have some on here already? I'm just gonna go just like that and then come back, and I basically just side swiped it. And then you can just do this number. You want to make sure it gets on there a little light. You don't want heavy drips like that happening. You know why? Because it's gonna dry like that. So you just want to a nice light coat to go on there. And on these sides, notice how I'm gonna follow the pattern of the, I'm gonna follow this pattern. Over here on the tops, I'm gonna go the other way. And I really love the Mod Podge. It dries so neat. It dries glossy. So a lot of you ask me questions about why is my paint not glossy? When I see yours on YouTube, your finished product is glossy. What happened? I did a painting and none of it's glossy. That's because you have to do this coat here. The gloss coat. And I'm gonna spray a sealer on top of this too, once this is completely dry. There's some junk in my Mod Podge there. I really need to strain this bucket of Mod Podge I got going on here. A lot of times it will just get junk in there from previous projects, and you know, there you have it. Okay, make sure I get that laid out real nice on there. Just go back and make sure that you do the sides real light, just real light with your brush, not any pressure at all, just the very, very tips touching it there. It's so dry in here right now. It's like 10 degrees outside, and our heat has been running, and when the heat runs, it's even more dry. You can see some of that started to bubble up there from the silicone. You can see some of those bubbles happening right there. And that's what I love about the Mod Podge. You just keep swiping it on there and those go away. Really nice. Really nice. Because a lot of other sealers, they come back. Okay. Do these sides here, and then we'll let this dry. And when you're down to your final coat, yeah, you want to make sure that your Mod Podge covers and you have enough, but you can always come back and put a little bit more on after it's dry. Okay, so we're going to let that dry at room temperature. If you want to put a high fan on this, you totally can. Feel free. But make sure it's not heat or hot. And be careful that you don't have a bunch of dirt in your fan that's gonna blow a bunch of junk across it. So you can see the lines in there, and it's gonna dry that way. But like I said, just if you blow dry it, don't do it with really hot heat, or it'll get real sticky and it could pull up your paint too. Okay, I'm all set up out here in the garage and got the fan right here ready to get blown after I'm done spraying these. But you can see what they look like, nice and shiny with that Mod Podge on there. But that Mod Podge just seals them up real nice. But what we're gonna do is something even better. You can still see the little lines in there. You can see that. But look at how it really brings out the gloss on there. But we are going to spray it with Rust-Oleum American Accents 2-Time Ultra Cover Gloss Clear. And we're going to put that on really thick. And then we're going to go inside as fast as possible because it stinks bad. So here we go. See if you can see it out there. I'm going to have to pull over here so I can see what's going on. And I'm going to put it as thick as possible on the top. I'm not really caring about runs or anything right now because it's going on a flat surface and it will be fine. Here and there. Oh, it still wants to bubble up down there on that one. Sometimes it will do that if you don't get the silicone off enough. See the little bubbles down there? Right there. But hopefully that will dry out. But see how this gloss really makes the paint glisten, and it will dry really shiny too. So I will show you the results after this. Here we are, shiny times. Okay, we're back in the garage, and look how wet looking that looks. But that is actually dry. That's dry to the touch. So now we're gonna put another coat on. And it's still gonna do its bubble thing, but that's okay. That's okay, cause it's gonna mellow out. It's gonna lay on down. Okay. You can see how it really wants to bubble up over there. And I don't think that's necessarily from the silicone. I don't normally start painting this quick from the Mod Podge. I usually let the Mod Podge sit there for a good long time, like a week or more. And then I go to putting this coat on. So I'm rushing things a bit, but it's still gonna work. Here is the finished product for these pieces. You can tell how shiny it is on there. You can see the little, see my wave lines that I did. So that's cool. And they almost match perfectly on the little edges there. And at first, I didn't even plan on doing these three, but they turned out really good. I hope you enjoyed the video, and When I sprayed the gloss on, it was really cold outside in the garage. I mean, like literally cold, cold. Not quite freezing, but maybe 40 degrees out there. And it really, when I sprayed the lacquer on there, it really made the lacquer lay out really nice. So I'm really happy with these. I hope you enjoy the video and you can watch more videos that I have if at the end of the video you just click on more. Okay, that sounded stupid.